If I could speak to my old self, knowing what I know now, I think the one thing I would tell myself is that I love you. Mainly because I feel like I didn't tell myself that enough when I was young. Now I do, and I feel the difference. I was disconnected from myself and lost, and I found self-love through brain education. My name is Arnel Querido, and I'm from Gilbert, Arizona. I found brain education at a health fair that my job was throwing. They had an oral reading booth set up, and I love doing any kind of reading, so of course I got one. And the person running the readings asked if I wanted to do a yoga class. And that's how I found the Body and Brain Centers, and that's where I learned brain education. During my first class, we did Danjan tapping and feeling energy. And it was a very unique experience for me trying Korean yoga for the first time. And afterward, the instructor asked if I wanted to do a healing session. And so I tried it. And during the healing session, she told me that she could tell I've hold a lot of emotion. And I remember hearing those words made me want to cry almost. I felt a lot of emotion come up in that moment. It was almost as if somebody saw me. And I didn't know why I was feeling those emotions. I didn't know what emotions were coming up. But it made me curious. It made me want to dig deeper and see what was inside of me. So because I'm naturally a very heady person, I think a lot. I don't spend much time considering my emotions and numbing myself. Feeling for the first time made me really curious. I wanted to dig deeper and see what else was inside of me. My greatest change through brain education was learning to feel myself again. I think at a very young age, being a boy, I was taught not to feel my emotions. And so for the majority of my life, I cut those emotions off and I stayed in my head, and I figured intelligence would get me farther in life than emotions. And I think something that really changed through brain education was I started feeling my body more, I started feeling my emotions more and accepting that this is part of me being human. And once I started feeling myself more, I noticed that my intuition became stronger. And what I realized is that my intuition is much stronger and much more powerful than my intelligence. So now I'm much better at following the voice inside of me that knows where I should go and what I should do. Even when it sounds crazy or illogical, there is a gut instinct inside of me that knows what I should do in every moment and what choices I should make that I wasn't making before, and it always made me unhappy. And now that I'm feeling myself more, now that I'm trusting myself more, and I feel those messages come up that, hey, you should go and do this, even when it sounds illogical, I know that it's where I should go and what I should do because I feel it deep inside of me. My favorite brain education exercise is bowing, because throughout my time practicing brain education, it's the one exercise I always came back to that I felt helped me grow and also to push past my limitations. It really helped me to feel my body and my emotions deeper. And even now, sometimes when I do bowing, I cry, I release a lot. It feels very healing. And for me, bowing is the perfect mind, body, spirit exercise when it's done right. If I could speak to my old self, knowing what I know now, I think the one thing I would tell myself is that I love you. Mainly because I feel like I didn't tell myself that enough when I was young. And now I do, and I feel the difference. I was disconnected from myself and lost, and I found self-love through brain education.